I can tell you one thing, Paddle. Mr. Harris knows exactly what he wants out of life. You should have seen that signature go down. Mr. Harris, our time is not too long, so look at the panel, will you? Tell us where you're from.
Los Angeles, California.
Now come with me, will you? Sit down right here, please. Because we haven't got time for you to go down on that hike in front of the panel, and we want them to have a good chance to guess what your occupation is, which always, in our ceremony, begins with a free guess. And Miss Dorothy Kilgallen always gets the first free guess.
I think he's a casting director.
A casting director, Mr. Allen.
It's like an executive of some sort, I'd say, in television.
Miss Francis.
I think he makes eyeglass rims.
Mr. Cirque.
He has a 10% gleam in his eye. I think he's an agent.
No, I'm afraid not. We'll let our viewers have a further look at Mr. Harris, and at the same time, we will tell them what his line is. All right, Mr. Harris, we have just a little time for the panel to get at you. You know what the rules are. We flip cards every time you give the no, and 10 of these flips and you're in. Mr. Harris is salaried. With that, we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf.
Mr. Harris, do you work for a profit-making organization?
Yeah, yes.
Is there anything surprising in the fact that this company makes a profit?
I didn't know till just now.
Is there a product involved in this work that you do?
No, there's no product as we use the term. $1 and $9 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Then you deal in services.
Correct.
Could both men and women avail themselves of your services?
Yes.
Do you require a considerable education or a high IQ in your work?
This is a rare thing. I am looking for this man. That's $2, $8 to go, Mr. Allen.
Are you anybody's boss?
No.
$3 and $7 to go, Miss Francis.
Do you work in an enclosure?
Not necessarily.
Now, wait a minute, I will say this, though, that it is likely to assume that the majority of your work would be done in an enclosure of some kind, yes?
Well,
I'll go along with that. We'll give you a qualified.
You just don't like to be indoors.
That's right. I'd rather be outside, but I'm in an enclosure.
Do people come to you?
Yes.
Are they glad to come to you?
Yes.
And
are they
no.
happy after they have seen you?
I think so.
And you say there is no product at all involved in what you do?
There is not a product in our termination.
No.
I see. Do you do any paperwork in your job?
Yes.
Do you have to have any knowledge of figures? I mean numbers.
No.
No, not specifically. $4 and $6 to go, Mr. Sir.
Do the people who come to you come to get permission to do something or to get a license for something?
No.
$5 and $5 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are they usually grown-ups?
Yes.
Do they do anything physical when they get where you are?
Sometimes.
Before they get to where I am or after they've gotten
there? After you see them, do they move around at all?
Yes, quite frequently.
Stand up and sit down?
Yes.
And you think it's fun?
I didn't say that.
Miss Dorothy. I must say that I think that Miss Dorothy is getting the germ of an idea, but our time is running out, so by default of time, and not the panel's fault, you get the full prize, and Mr. Harris, you're going to be very happy to hear, is a television gag writer.
Oh!
Whom do you do this for now?
Does this give you a clue?
Jackie Gleason?
Jackie Gleason, yeah.
All right, Mr. Harris, thanks very much for being with us. Nice to have you.